Life lesson number one, folks. If you're going to start a homestead channel, keep stuff around. Last video I put up, I get some people crying the blues about how I got too much junk around the place. It looks like a hoarder. It's a dump. Do you know what this guy did cleaning up? I wanted to clean it up myself too because I thought it was starting to look like I had too much stuff. But here's what I did. That mower, I had parts for it. I blew this morning. Blew the belt, blew the pulley. That pulley was seized, I guess, and wasn't spinning. It sat for a long time. What did I do? I had one for parts and I took it for scrap. So, those of you folks who are crying the blues about having too much stuff around, I imagine you folks can't fix your own stuff. You have to take it to a garage and get it fixed. Which, there's nothing wrong with that. You know, some people do that. Nothing wrong with that. But for a fellow like me who fixes his own stuff, I need a lot of that stuff around. So, and perhaps, I don't know, maybe you're to the age now where you don't like clutter around. Maybe you live in town and you can't do that. Guarantee you, any of you folks who ever grew up on a farm, an older farm, probably had a little pile out behind the barn where you kept your scrap because you needed it. And that was a wise thing to do. I clean up my stuff thinking, doing a good thing. Pulley goes, belt goes. I took one for scrap. The only thing I kept off it was a few pulleys. This is one of the pulleys I put on there a long time ago, and the one I upgraded it from a plastic to a metal one. So I have that I saved. Or otherwise, that little guy there is about $50, folks. So, you know, I do read the comments and I do take a lot of suggestions to heart if they make sense. Now, some of you folks get on there, I think you're just not having a good day, you're off your meds, whatever, it's getting late in the day, I don't know, you're grouchy, it's too early. I don't know what's going on when people post bad things on YouTube videos. It is neither here nor there. I have some good people there that understand and they defend us, like Osseo, Jeff Ketcherside. Perfect guys I'm talking about. They read the comments before I can, and they reply, and they're really good because they've lived this and they know what it's like to live half hour away from town up north. If you needed this, you don't just go buy this at a hardware store. You order that in. You're looking at 3 or 4 days to order something that in. At least you're looking at $50 and a few days down. I keep a little pile of scrap. If people don't like it, I'm in that much degrees of the compass, there's lots around. 360 degrees, in fact, folks. Anyway, my point being is, it doesn't bother me. But I thank you folks for defending me on there. I really appreciate it. But it really doesn't bother me. I mean, Heather sometimes checks comments. She says, you should see what somebody wrote. And for the most part, what do I tell you, Heather?
I don't care.
Yeah, that's what I say. I don't care. You know, I understand. I've never been one to live my life to please others. And if you start living that way, you're not living your own life, you're living other people's. And perhaps when I get a certain age, I'm going to be bitter too. But I'm not. So, I go to my brother's place looking for a belt because I didn't have one. And I didn't have a pulley because I cleaned out all my stash. Actually, I had this pulley. And I had to look for a while because I thought I had it. I almost took it for scrap. Glad I didn't. Belt, I got rid of them. And I should not have. So, I'll show you what I brought home. I brought this home. Look at that. Pretty much the same as mine. They gave it to me. Good for parts. I want to take you up to the old house and show you what else I got. So I actually just took the belt off there. I'm actually trying to figure out how this goes on. So I took the belt off. I put it on there. Pulley's rusty on the top, but it's pretty smooth inside. And I did put a plastic one on there because it's the right, you know, whatever. It's what I had when it was new, so I put it back on. I took it over here. You see where it used to go on right here. But I'll show you what else I got. And this engine don't look bad either. So I got a spare engine, you know, a spare tire, spare rims. I can keep this thing going for a long time. And it is not going to cost me anything. It's not going to cost me a dime. I don't have to race out and spend $1,400, $1,500 on a new lawnmower, ride-on mower. This guy will do the same thing as a pretty new one at a fraction of the price. So, I'll show you the other one I got up at the house. Let's go for a walk, folks. I'm going to take my battery. And I'll show you what I got. I got a second one. It's a a little smaller. But now, once we start mowing all this, Heather can jump on the other one and mow too. I just need a mower deck for it. So, yeah, so I mean, you know, I show what we do around here because I'm not... See, this stuff isn't even mine right here. This stuff don't even belong to me. Belongs to a friend. He moved, an older fella. Needed a place to store his stuff. And I said, out of the goodness of my heart, go ahead and store it there. It doesn't bother me.
We're not ashamed of it. That's the thing.
Like, no, we're not ashamed of the stuff we store here.
Shameful thing.
Yeah.
We're dreaming that we're going to be upset.
Yeah, you're wasting your keyboard and your power.
Time, go troll somebody
else. Yeah, go troll someone else. It doesn't bother us, folks. I actually get a kick out of it. Because I know what it's like. You want to see this one here? I just did some work on this one. Now, the mower deck's bad on it, but look it. Another freebie. It needs the tires fixed. I just spent 20 minutes on it. It was a simple fix. I got that thing running. The mower deck has to be fixed and some tires need air. Do you want to see something? I'm going to show you this. So if you folks is trolling, I really don't care. I think it's funny. So go ahead and waste your time. Because I think a lot of people on here, on this channel, realize you're wasting your time too. Because I really don't care. Now, you want to see something? Watch this. Push in on the clutch. Maybe I'll give it a little choke here. Oh, can you grab the key off the other one, Heather, please?
Yep.
Is it on the other mower? The one I was fixing?
Yep. I'll go.
Thanks. Oh, it's on the fender. It's got, you know, that long keychain that's in there?
Yeah. Oh, the one you showed me.
Yes. That's the key I need for this. Yeah. Unless I can use a screwdriver. Well, if you go get that, that'd be great. Anyways, I'll show you. Look at this. Dirty, but you know what? I'll get a few summers easy out of that. Like, I can just keep fixing them. I'm not the kind of person who has to run out. Sorry about that wind. I don't know if that's affecting it. I'm not the type of person who has to run out and buy everything new because I can fix this stuff and I really like that. So yes, I like to keep aluminum around because I weld things up out of aluminum. I keep wire around because I use it. If I got to splice a wire or something, repair a wire on a vehicle that comes in, I like to have different sizes of wire, and that's exactly what's in here. Different sizes of wire. If I got to repair something for somebody, I just go over here, hack a piece of wire out. So yeah, everything I have here. I keep some stuff. I think I'm not going to use it. I get rid of it, you know. I pick this up from my brother's. 240 volt or 12240 volts. 12240. 3600 watts. I was running it with this and it was running my generator and my plasma. Right now I need that one runs my compressor. That one runs a plasma. This guy ran both. It ran the plasma and the compressor. So I'll hook my diesel engine up to that, and that'll drive that. Oh, thanks, babe, for the keys. Now, you want to see something? Watch this, okay? This is why it does not bother me a bit. I'm just going to turn the key. Oh, I guess I have to put this. This has to be up. That's why. Let's see. Push the choke in. Maybe I have to choke it some more. Well, it started a minute. Was it out of gas? Well, there's still gas in there. Did I flood it? We're not sure, but it did start a while ago. I flooded it, babe. needs a little carb cleaning. The only thing is the wire shut off here. I'm not sure where the shut off switch is, but it's not shutting off right now. Won't shut off with the key, but that's just a simple key switch. But now we'll see if it'll start. I choked it to shut it off, so. It's flooding, see that? Because I shut it off. So to start it, obviously, I gotta give it a little throttle because I flooded it to shut it off. Not bad for a freebie?
No.
Didn't take much to get it running, eh?
This is another thing people don't remember. Is that,
yeah, I can fix all this.
Well, yeah, and also, he built the homestead.
Sorry, babe.
Well, that's okay.
Go ahead.
I think people don't realize is that this homestead was built because of the junk that's around here.
Yes.
Like that helped you build your sawmill.
My sawmill I built out of scrap I collected.
Yeah.
All the brackets on the fence,
yeah,
I built out of scrap. Like,
yeah,
just about everything I built out of here was stuff.
Yeah.
My dozer I used to clear the land. People give up on it. It was scrap.
Exactly.
I got it fixed. I fixed it out of parts. The little mower we're using gonna be going for scrap. He didn't want it anymore. Cause they didn't want it. They're too far away to take it to get it fixed. That's the thing.
So,
and it's cost too much. So we get that. We can fix it pretty cheap.
Yeah. And so, like, that's the thing is, maybe people think it's, like don't, granted, it looks...
It does look messy.
It looks
messy.
And, you know what I mean? But we're fine with that.
Yeah.
And if you're not, well...
Move on.
Sorry.
Yeah. Not really.
Not really.
sorry.
Sorry.
Yeah. But, I mean, that's a prime example. This little guy was laying in the scrap pile.
Yeah.
Somebody brought it in, dropped off because it wouldn't run anymore. 20 minutes, I have it running. And then I just adjusted the carburetor so it runs even better. So now I got to figure out why it won't shut off. But look at this now, watch. I hit the key. Hey, what do you think? But I have to go out the mower deck though. I don't know why the mower deck spins all the time. I think the little brakes aren't working and it's probably not lifted up all the way to loosen the belt. But it drives good. I mean, nothing wrong with the way it drives. And it does mow grass. I tested it when I drove it up here with flat tires and it ran great. There was nothing wrong with it. So, I fix the mower deck, we'll have a good spare mower.
We will. And you did a good job on it.
Well, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Sorry, so I didn't mean to rant, but for those of you folks that leave comments about how messy it is around here, we don't care. You're not really hurting us. You're not telling us anything we don't know.
No.
And you're not hurting our feelings. And I'm not getting rid of the stuff I want to keep. We're not, even my YouTube channel, I'm not doing it to, it's an income. That's what it is. It helps us survive. So, I mean, other than that.
And we like to meet the people.
We love to meet new people, yes. We like to meet good people. There's a lot of good people we met that understands our way of life. We like it. For the folks that who don't understand our way of life, maybe your channel is maybe a cooking channel or, I don't know,
really
waxing your car type channel. I don't know.
Really pretty.
Yeah, maybe you want to go look at. Yeah, maybe you want to go look at million-dollar homes in Hollywood, but you're not going to see it here. If you're looking at homestead channels, for the folks who do their own work, you're going to see scrap out by their place. So, you know, if you haven't figured that out by now, you might be one of the slow ones, maybe. I'm just saying. Anyways, not everybody has that, though. Not every homestead has that. But every homestead who does their own mechanical work is probably going to have parts laying around, you know, unless they're really close to a store or have a lot of money. Anyways, I'm going to get at that other mower, and I want to get it repaired. So Heather and I, once it's cleaned up, we can spend our time. See, we got a lot of our stuff done now. We don't need to keep a lot of scrap around. We did when we were building the mill, and if I hadn't kept scrap around, I would not have had pipes to roll that house, right?
No, that's absolutely correct.
As it was, Osseo, Steve Pritchard, a really good friend of ours, brought over a roll of pipe, and we used that. So thanks a lot,
yeah,
Steve.
Yeah, it was very nice of him to do that. He's been really good to us, and we appreciate it.
So anybody that's
Tony Hammerling.
Oh, yeah, everybody, yeah. Yeah.
Big Daddy. There's so many people that have been so good to us.
Yeah, and they understand what we're striving for. We want to be self-reliant,
exactly.
And let's face it, being self-reliant, you have to be able to fix your own stuff, grow your own stuff, process your own stuff. And when I say process your own stuff, I even mean stuff like this. You have to know how to process that. People back in the day, they didn't just have one horse around. They had two in case one horse broke down.
That's true.
One lawnmower, if this one breaks down, I have a spare lawnmower. I'm just not feeding this thing when it's shut off. I don't have to put it in the barn. I don't have to water it. My other lawnmower breaks down, I have a spare one. Same as people with parts for vehicles up here. If somebody has a pickup truck, chances are they'll have a spare one for parts if they know how to fix it. Because why? If that one breaks down, they use the other one or take parts off of it.
Exactly.
Obviously, with horses back in the day, you're not going to, if one needed a heart transplant, you're not ripping a heart out of the other and putting it, you're just going to jump on that other horse and go.
That's true.
This is a way of life that people have lived for a long time. People just don't have it upstairs to draw the parallel or whatever you call it.
Yeah, it's a different, people are different. And some people are good with one thing and some
people understand it, people don't.
Yeah.
But it's the people that get on there with a negative comment so that are not doing any good for anybody.
No.
They're not happy with their lives and they have to push that hatred and disappointment that they've had in their lives on somebody else.
Yeah.
And you can see it clearly on there. That's why when you tell me somebody's put a bad comment on my channel, what do I tell you again?
I don't care.
Say it louder.
I don't care.
That's what I say. So folks, go ahead. Keep them up. Makes us money. Negative comments, dislikes, likes. Doesn't matter to us. Anyways.
unless they start getting...
Unless it's racist or mean, then
like,
I remove
if it's
it.
Like, if you're
and I will block them instantly.
If you're putting on constant negative comments... Well,
then they get blocked.
You're going to be blocked.
And then have to make up another channel.
Yeah.
It's just starting to sprinkle. But that's how our turkeys are doing. I think they're missing the human... contact, eh? They seem pretty content in there. Are you guys happy? And come say hi? I think that was a male. pretty sure. They won't, look at this, look at this, look at this. They're already starting. No, he's not doing it. Sometimes they get in a tougher zone. They're shivering, it's not even cold out. Come on guys, toughen up. I guess maybe they don't like the wind. Sometimes they drop their wings there and they start to try to look like turkeys. They look like prehistoric beasts. They look like those creatures off of Jurassic Park. So you gonna say hi to the camera? Or what? Big fat zero. Well, we're gonna let them continue doing their turkey things, and I am going to go inside, I think. Yeah, you can see the males, eh? They're already trying to look tough. It's funny.